You're listening to the John and Heidi Show, now featuring the wit and wisdom of Dan Farris.
Okay, dudes, let's walk this sucker.
On Sunny 93.3.
It's the John and Heidi Show bonus hour with Dan Farris. Good day to you.
Oh, here we are saddling up again after another action-packed weekend.
What'd you do this weekend, Dan?
It was, well, I did the usual, you know, I ignored yard work. I got a broken screen door, and I kind of passed that by.
Oh, is your screen door broken again?
Yeah.
What happened to it now?
It has been for, oh gosh, since early spring.
The one that we fixed?
Well, you fixed the handle.
Oh,
that was something different.
What's wrong with it?
Busted another piece of hardware that, what is it, the cylinder with
the air that closes it automatically.
Easy peasy. I can stop by and fix that.
Well, my little plan has come together.
You only mentioned it once. How many times did you mention the handle before I fixed it?
Well, you know, and it seems to me the bathtub could use a re-caulking. I just can't seem to find the time to get to those things, John. I had a lot going on.
I've got a lot going on.
Sitting around being ruggedly handsome pretty much exhausts me.
I'll bet it does.
Let's see. Who's got birthday today? Is Dave Chappelle.
Oh, hey, he's a funny dude.
He's a pretty talented guy. Dave is 47 today.
Nice.
Okay, for $1 million. And it will have to be a post-dated check if you win. Hal Smith has a birthday today. Hal Smith, famous for?
I have no idea.
He was Oklahoma Buccaneers.
Ooh, you are so close to
him. Is that even a team?
No. No, but you're close. Well, only because his character started with an O. Otis Campbell from the Andy Griffith Show.
Oh, I loved Otis.
Berries, little Karina and little juicer there, a little drunk.
So where are the Buccaneers? They're not from Oklahoma?
They're kind of a little bit east and south down in Tampa Bay, John. Florida. Yep. And who else? You know him, you love him. Steve Guttenberg.
Oh, yes.
Oh, I loved him. I did love him.
From Police Academy. And he's doing just a great job. About the only show that every week I go, okay, I've got to tune this in on ABC. Holy moly.
He's on that?
He is a guest judge on occasion, and he's hilarious.
I haven't seen him in years. I'm going to have to tune that in.
Steve Guttenberg is 62 today.
Nice.
Speaking of which, is there a connection? Let's find out. It was this day in 1456, the printing of the Gutenberg Bible is completed.
Oh, that was the first book ever printed on the Gutenberg press.
There you go.
Okay.
Steve's great-great-grandfather.
18, well, be
possibly.
A little greater than that is 1456.
He was very great-great.
1853, Chef George Crum prepares the very first potato chips. Yeah, at Moon's Lake House right outside Saratoga Springs, New York.
Yeah, I read the story about that, too. I
love the fact that it was potato chips and his last name is Crum. Just irony!
Originally, they were called Saratoga chips.
Okay. 1981, Mark David Chapman sentenced 20 years to life for the murder of John Lennon.
Oh, yeah.
Well, since 81, in case you don't know, since that day, this guy, Mark David Chapman, he has been up for parole 10 times.
Oh, really?
Tonight, of course, all 10 times. And he's up again this month, actually, for the 11th time. In fact, it may have already happened, but I don't think
you don't follow that?
Ever getting out.
Probably not.
Yeah, that was crazy.
Great stuff, Dan. Thank you for that update.
Absolutely. I know now. You know now. We all know, and we're just going to forge ahead bravely.
We will do it together right here on the John and Heidi Show Bonus Hour with Dan Farris.
Do you pay too much for insurance? Have you looked around? Or are you too chicken? Don't be afraid to look around to see if you can find a better deal at insurancechicken.com. We make it super simple for you to see rates from several different companies to see what they have to offer all in one place. Peck out great insurance deals at insurancechicken.com. Is it time for you to cross the road? See if we can save you money each month at insurancechicken.com. That's insurancechicken.com.
Time now for Ranger Dan's Critter Corner.
Well, I'm rough, tough, and ready. I'm a heck of a man. Eat my beans and weenies from a frying pan.
He's Ranger Dan.
Easy. I'm Ranger Dan. Well, I love to wrestle bears and lasso ducks, run over possums in my government truck.
He's Ranger Dan.
Easy. I'm Ranger Dan. Well, I loves all the campers and the animals, too. If you're picking on critters, I'm coming after you.
He's Ranger Dan.
Yes, sir. I'm Ranger Dan.
Good morning, Ranger Dan.
Good morning, Ranger Dan.
Oh, happy Monday there. My favorite long-time married couple in the whole darn world. Look at you, Phil. You're looking average. Hey, Heidi.
Ranger Dan.
Well, seems to me you should change your name to Google. Because you're everything I'm searching for.
That was a good one.
Oh, I had the effort there. I think I might have blown a kidney just thinking that through. You know, the requests just don't stop, and I've been trying to kind of hold back, get away from it a little, but goodness gracious me, in these supposedly dark times in which we're traveling, America does need a good laugh, which is,
for sure.
Which is why we released my comedy album, Ranger Dan Quacks You Up.
I'm a huge fan, by the way.
Recorded initially sometime back in January during a Two for Tuesday at Critter's Peanut Bar, no longer offering peanuts, Cheetah's Peanut Bar. It's somewhere right outside Sisson in South Dakota, which is still ruled by the French.
Yes, it is.
People want to hear a little bit more. People like to chuckle. And if I can shed a little light on any little Radio Ranger's life, well, gosh darn it, I'll do it. So here's just another little sampling of what you're going to hear from Ranger Dan Quack You Up. Available for just $29.95 plus $12.95 shipping and handling. Ranger Dan website. Just click on the little chuckling duck icon. Allow 37 to 53 weeks for delivery. Here we go. Strap yourselves in because this stuff is just gosh darn funny. What do you get from a pampered cow?
What?
Spoiled milk! Catch your breath. Hey there, little Radio Rangers. What do you do if your hamster eats your pencil?
What?
Use a pen. Wait, is this thing on?
Yeah.
They can't all be home runs, I tell you what. All right, here we go. Let's wrap it up because I just can't take it. I know you can't either. Where do you find a dog with no legs? Pretty much right where you left it. Oh, I redeemed myself there. Hey, little Radio Rangers. Go to school, do something, get busy. This is Ranger Dan out. Say it with me.
Yes, sir.
Some credit cards have really high rates or big annual fees. Usually, people sign up for these when it's all they qualify for. If that sounds like you, it may be time to get a better credit card. Over time, your situation changes, and you may qualify for a better credit card. Your current card hopes you don't think about it, but our site shows you many options to see if there's a better credit card for you. Check it out for free at bettercreditcards.com. That's bettercreditcards.com.
Time now for Water Cooler Talk with Mr. Dan Farris, brought to you by Lukewarm Tap Water.
What's going on? Schools are firing up. You know what? Some universities are not opening, going to be online. Some are given all kinds of options. You can do some online. You can visit campus once or twice a week if it's something that has to be face-to-face. And all the options. Here's what's going on at SDSU. For the Jacks, face masks are required.
Okay.
You on campus, everybody, administrators, employees, students, everybody is wearing masks. In fact, all students, if they're coming back, are going to be handed a little kit having to do with jackrabbit swag and everything else, plus two masks.
Okay.
And if you don't have one, you can sure find one. If you don't care to wear one, they do have policies in place where it's either, hey, put it on, or you're basically going to be asked to leave.
Yep.
Okay. That's where it's at SDSU. They say they want to work with everybody, keep everybody safe and healthy, but they're going to be open for business. But yeah, you are going to cover up. It's been pretty interesting to me. I was talking to, ran into a couple of young ladies who actually attend, help
USF.
Me out here, home of the Cougars, USF.
USF yeah,
thanks, John.
You're welcome.
And they had recently gotten emails about the start of school, and I think they're both going into either their second or third year there. And they said it was just confusing because there were four different options that were given to them for how to proceed into this school year. And they're just going, you know what? And one of them actually said, had I known this was coming, I just would have set my schooling up totally online a year ago.
Right.
Would have saved me a ton of money.
Right.
And I would have gotten the same results.
Yep.
So it is interesting because both of my children have been to college, Luke and Sadie.
Mm-hmm.
And Sadie Hayes last year wanted to up her teaching degree. She did every bit of it online from home. Mm-hmm. Now, Luke, my son, he's doing the same thing come fall. And he's doing it all online. Mm-hmm. I talked to him just the other day. So you're going to have to show up to campus or what? He went, oh, no, that's not happening. So it's pretty interesting what's happening, especially with higher education, which can be so expensive.
Right.
But part of what you're paying for is that campus life experience. It just is. You know, if you're 18, 19 years old, you want to be hanging out in the commons. You want to go down.
Sure.
You want to go, you know, hit Whiskey Row on Saturday night, whatever.
You want to get the whole experience.
Yeah, the whole experience. So I think it's, yeah, the fallout from this thing is going to.
It's going to be huge.
I think it's really going to change the face of higher education as we move along. So
I agree.
It's not just
fascinating.
That, but so many things that is changing. Because there are a lot of people who, right now, with businesses, you know, where people are working from home. So not only are the people enjoying working from home, but in addition to that, the companies are enjoying the savings of not having to have.
Well, it's close home to me, too. I mean, I had a great side hustle going on for years at the farmer's market over at 8th and Railroad.
Oh,
and this year, yeah, I completely had to just fold up my kissing booth. Yeah.
Oh, I didn't even know you were
it
doing that.
It affects everybody. It's affecting everyone.
Dan, you are a victim. I didn't know it. I apologize for not.
That was a real cash cow.
I'll bet it was.
But I've saved a lot on chapstick.
So it all evens itself out.
And I haven't been to the free clinic in months.
Oh, that's good. Silver line. All right. You're listening to the John and Heidi Show Bonus Hour with Dan Farris. Water cooler talk brought to you by Lukewarm Tap Water.
Tap water.
We're here to make it better.
If you find that drug or alcohol problems are hitting you too close to home, you can get help. Maybe it's time for rehab. Your insurance may even cover everything. Learn more at timeforrehab.com. Get help for a drug or alcohol problem within 24 hours.
We're here to make it better.
Get more information at timeforrehab.com. That's timeforrehab.com.
Time now for our Bright Spot of News, brought to you by Paul's Designer Showroom on Lake Lorraine in Sioux Falls. Today, our Bright Spot shines on a really fun thing that we've been doing with our friends from Clean Cut Lawn Care. We're helping heroes, and I've got on the line right now, I've got Jared from Clean Cut Lawn Care. How you doing, sir?
I'm doing good, alive and well.
That's alive and well is a good way to start the week, isn't it?
It is. The
so,
best way.
And I also want to remind people, if you know somebody that's a veteran, a first responder, a person who is currently serving in the military or the family of one of those people who are serving in the military, they can all register or you can nominate them at sunnyradio.com. Scroll down on the page and you'll see that Helping Heroes right on the page there. And now, since I've got you on the line, Jared, let's talk a little bit about what you do, because in addition to mowing lawns, you do other things too, right?
Yeah, I do. Right now, we're trying to get ready for winter months coming ahead. So, you know, we want to get the irrigation system going. We want to be seeding, overseeding and fertilizing, and dethatching if we need to.
So if somebody listening would like to get some assistance with those things, maybe they don't qualify for the contest that we're doing, but they would like to get some assistance, how do they get a hold of you? What's the best way to reach you?
So you can get a hold of me on my phone number at 605-906-0532.
And we've got that information on our page as well. So if you go to sunnyradio.com, you'll see his info right there with the Helping Heroes button and all of the information to register. Once again, if you're a first responder, if you're a veteran, or if you're active duty military or their family, we would love to have you as our winner next time. And again, it's all at sunnyradio.com. Jared, thank you for doing this with us. I think it's really, really cool.
Hey, thank you, John, for having me do it.
Absolutely. Again, Jared with Clean Cut Lawn Care. If you'd like to reach out to him, again, all of his information is also on our page at sunnyradio.com. This has been today's Bright Spot of News, brought to you by Paul's Designer Showroom on Lake Lorraine in Sioux Falls. Many people have dabbled in the stock market for their very first time ever this year. If you're new to the market, but you don't want to learn things the hard way and the expensive way, I encourage you to subscribe to this free newsletter. You can get the inside track with Wall Street's brightest minds delivered directly to your inbox every day at marketbeatminute.com. Subscribe for free. If you change your mind, just unsubscribe. Sign up for free right now at marketbeatminute.com. That's marketbeatminute.com. Time now for a little bit of entertainment news of the day with Mr. Dan Farris.
Because celebrities.
Yeah.
I found this kind of interesting. Tripped over this. It's actually published in Rolling Stone magazine. Came from one of the late night talk show hosts. They started a poll based on the fact that our president, Donald Trump, he was a celebrity.
Mm-hmm.
You know, in a sense, we elected a celebrity.
Right.
And so this poll has to do with, here are lists of celebrities. If we were to elect another celebrity president, what would the preference be?
Honey Boo Boo.
Honey Boo Boo. Whoa.
You got a list?
You know, I didn't scroll that far down, actually. But it is kind of fascinating, and it may not necessarily be celebrities that you would think right off the bat.
The fave, Oprah's on the list.
Top of the heap. Oprah is, but she's certainly not number one. Morgan Freeman takes the cake. Yeah.
Mm. He's been the president in movies, and I don't...
Yeah, so that's probably where a lot of that comes from.
Yeah,
people can see him in that role because they've seen him in that
role. Well, he's, though, in real life, though, just kind of really level-headed, pretty smart, just...
You know who I would say?
So.
Denzel.
Denzel really? Is barely behind Morgan Freeman.
Oh, wow.
Actually. Nice. Morgan Freeman got 81% of the vote. Denzel Washington, 76%.
Jerry Sinise on there?
Percent. He's not. Tom Hanks, Samuel L. Jackson.
It's Tom Hanks.
Each won 73%.
Hmm.
And Dwayne The Rock Johnson fell just behind them at 72%.
So you apparently could vote for more than one because there's a lot of.
So Samuel L. Jackson. Is on there, but people are offended by Donald Trump. Doesn't that seem a little counterproductive?
Well, it depends on who's doing the offending.
And I like Sam Jackson. He's a funny guy. He's offensive, but funny.
And the way it breaks out, if it were just among Republicans, Morgan Freeman, still up there with 86%, followed by Judge Judy at 81%.
Really?
Clint Eastwood's clocking in at 80%. NASCAR star Dale Earnhardt Jr. at 79%. Tim Allen. At 78%. Oh,
I loved him, Al.
Wow. And among Democrats, Jackson was the runaway favorite.
Yeah.
At 87%.
Samuel Jackson?
Yep.
Which is funny because they're the ones that are so offended by the way Donald Trump speaks.
Hmm.
Followed by Tom Hanks at 82%, Morgan Freeman at 81%, and then with the Democrats, all of a sudden, back in the race is George Clooney at 80%, and Oprah Winfrey at number 5 with 78% of the vote.
Well, there you go.
I thought that was just kind of fascinating.
For the election, we'll never see. Good to know.
Will happen again, because technically, when you think about it, back in the 80s, I mean, you know, Ronald Reagan, before he was governor of California, he was an actor.
Yep.
Yeah.
I mean, he did bedtime for Bonzo, for goodness sakes.
He did indeed.
And he was one of the greatest presidents we've ever had.
Yeah, so you never know.
On the list, the only one that you mentioned that I know of that was also in politics is Clint Eastwood, because he...
Correct.
He was actually...
Carmel by the Sea. He was mayor.
And he did a great job.
And, again, I could see him, you know, he's kind of the stay off my lawn, you little punk. But I could see him.
Not that there's anything wrong with that.
Not at all.
Dan says as he's getting ready to say that to a kid.
When I was your age,
my lawn, you little
took
punk.
Us 8 hours to make a baked potato.
You know, Heidi,
and we loved it.
Like one day that I realized I was getting old when there were some kids cutting through our lawn every day, and I went outside to tell them to knock it off.
I was like, it's
so you're
a
yelling
lawn.
At these kids for walking on our lawn? The lawn that you won't even mow.
I had kids in my neighborhood. One of them was actually skateboarding, jumping up my front steps right to the front door of my house.
Yeah, that's...
But I went, cool. Kids are outside playing, man. Go nuts. Do whatever you want.
Yeah, you guys have fun.
Because you don't see it very often anymore.
There you go. Well, Dan, thank you for that report, sir.
My pleasure.
You are listening to the John and Heidi Show Bonus Hour with Dan Farris.
If you have a credit card, we'd like to help you make sure it's the best credit card for you. Take a few minutes to look at your current interest rate and see what you get for points or perks. Then go to bettercreditcards.com to see if we can help you find a better credit card. This will literally cost you nothing, and it could help you get a better credit card. If you don't have a credit card right now, you can check us out too at bettercreditcards.com. That's bettercreditcards.com.
Here's your Market Beat Minute for Monday, August 24th, 2020. The S&P 500 made a move above its pre-COVID all-time high on Friday. The move was driven by a round of better-than-expected economic data that paints a bright picture for the U.S. economy. The data includes flash readings on the manufacturing and services sector, readings that both show a marked acceleration in economic activity. In the technical sense, although Friday's price action was bullish and set a new all-time high, it still leaves a lot to be desired. The price action closed at the high of the day, but the candle was small and the breadth was weak. If there's no follow-through on Monday, the markets could be in for another week of sideways trading at best. Looking ahead at the next week, there are two potential catalysts in the second quarter GDP revisions and Friday's release of the personal income and spending figures. You can get the inside track with Wall Street's brightest minds delivered directly to your inbox every day at marketbeatminute.com.